Hey everyone, the DaVinci Resolve 19 Beta 6 was just released. This is kind of like an extra video. I just want to do something since it was just released and get that uploaded quickly. So not doing a whole lot of editing or anything. Just want to go over the new features that we see from here. So as you can see here, I'm on the Blackmagic forum. This is where you can actually see all of that stuff. If you want how to get there, you can easily go to blackmagicdesign.com, okay, and then you just come over to forum and you can come down to DaVinci Resolve, and this is where you're going to find all the new stuff. So as you see, we now have the public beta, and right here is going to say about the public beta 6. So let's click that, and right here on the first post shows everything there. So that's how you get here. All right, and I'll leave a link in the description below, so if you need to find that, go ahead and check that. So here we have what's new in DaVinci Resolve. There's a whole bunch of stuff going on here. Down here, you see there's a lot of stuff that was addressed, which were previous issues, and the rest is going to be in here. So we're going to take a look at, you know, a few of these and see. Now here, we have new haliation saturation controls for the Resolve effects film look creator, so we'll take a look at that. Import and export speaker tag transitions as SRTX subtitle files. So if you're doing like a podcast or something, this is really going to be helpful. Here, the new stinger templates in the effects library under generators. This is really awesome. We're going to take a look at that. All right, so there's a bunch of cut timeline stuff. Yeah, I don't use the cut page, so I'm not really going to get into any of that stuff. Transitions are now retained when ripple deleting clips. This is a really cool one. Yeah, that's really going to help a lot. Improved mouse scroll speeds in the edit and deliver timelines. That's going to be helpful. Really speed up the workflow. Greatly improved performance on some large Fusion compositions. That'll be great. If you're working in the Fusion page and you're doing some really big stuff there, your performance will be enhanced. That's awesome. Support for collaboration using Blackmagic Cloud organizational groups. You know, that's really going to be nice too if you're working together with someone. Here, rendered DNX HR444 clips now default to using full data range. Oh, okay, that's really nice. You're gonna not lose the color. You see the 444, that means that you're not going to be losing any information on the color and stuff using that. So that's really nice if you're using the DNX HR 444. That's really good. Oh yeah, and there's one more I want to take a look is support for changing audio format for the timeline clips in the inspector. So yeah, that sounds really good, but we'll have to take a look and see. So let's jump on into the edit page of DaVinci Resolve and take a look at a couple of these things. All right, so here we go. What you're seeing here is for tomorrow's video that's coming out. So yeah, let's take a look at the audio first. We'll click on that, and we're supposed to find something here in the inspector. So I've checked, but I don't see any new windows. I don't see anything out of the ordinary. As you know, when you're changing things to help like the bounce of the audio or something, you know, what you can do is right click here and go to clip attributes and bring this up. However, if you want to learn how to do that, check the video I have linked above, and that'll help you get your audio balanced. If it's only coming out of one speaker, you'll definitely want to check that out. And that's what we're supposed to have over here, but I'm not seeing it. I've searched around. If you come over here to the file, and this is where I can see something. I'm not sure if this is different than before, but you can see here it is set at 2-channel stereo. And if you click that, you can click on custom, and that's just going to bring you right to where the clip attributes were. I'm not sure if this was what the update is or not. If you can let me know in the comments below if you know what it is, you know, please do. Hopefully they are going to add that here on the inspector, because that would be really useful. Everything we can do on the edit page with the audio is really going to help our workflow out. Okay, so the next one, let's get into that haliation. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to come down here to the end, because I don't really have a cinematic clip on here. I just have for me for this. Get into the color page, and as you can see, I have my node tree that I built out is here. Let me close. There we go. And I'll just select this one. I'm going to press Option S, create a new node. If you want to learn how to build this node tree, go ahead, check the video I have above, and that'll help you build this. Really super simple, but great for YouTube. And then, okay, I'm going to use this one. Let's go to Effects. I'm going to use the Film Look Creator. Drop that on there and see what the new, as you can see, that just changed it like that. And close this down, because the new thing that's available is under the haliation. The haliation helps with stuff like say around the lights here. So I'll show you, if I increase, you can see what's going on there. Kind of like makes it kind of glow and wrap that a little bit. Let me reset that one. The radius, you know, as you can see what's going on there. But the new one here is the saturation, which is pretty cool. So it adds, as you can see there, right on the edge, it adds some saturation, where you can desaturate whatever you need to do there. So that is for the film look creator. Let's go back onto the edit page. Now they mentioned about the mouse. So let's see, I mean, it's supposed to scroll pretty good. So let's get in there detailed. Let me scroll. I'm using my little side scroll for that. I mean, it's not really a big deal there. Nothing's really overdoing anything. Let's zoom in and out and see. All right, and try with the shifting wheel. Okay, I mean, it is what it is. You know, I do have a video about the editing with the mouse. If you want to check that out, go ahead and check that video there. How about we're going to do one more. We're going to jump into, there's the new generators. Oh yeah, these ones are really awesome. Let me bring this back down. That way we get it nice and big and we can see what those generators are. Click on generator. So you're going to come over here to your effects library. Okay. And down here under video transitions, straight down to generators. It's right here. So you click on generators and then we can come down. And you see here we have stinger transition. And we'll just go over them. So there's a logo from left to right. 3D text, rotate. Zoom. All right. Here we go. Band wipe. Blobs. Broadcast news. Wonder how editable that is. We'll check out some of the editable stuff here in a bit. That's interesting. Okay. It'd be nice if all these colors are editable. All right, so there's a handful of them. So now let's go ahead and check a couple of them and see how editable they are. So now you have the 3D logo from the left to right, which is pretty cool. So you can put a custom logo. Let's drag and drop that and see what it looks like here. So we got this here, 3D logo and image file. So if you have something there, let me see if I can find one real quick. Okay, so it looks like it should be PNG, not a TIFF. I just wanted to test that. So here we go. I'm gonna open this PNG and see how that is. All right, I just had to reset something. So there we go. I mean, that's pretty cool. Kind of smooth. Let's see what kind of adjustments. Let's see, there's glow on there, so I can take that glow. Ah, okay, that's interesting. We can make the glow size, glow blend. We can blend it in and out. The edge, light rays. Oh, wow. Oh, that's pretty cool. We can do some fancy stuff with that. Light rays intensity, so let's jack that up. So add light rays, and let's mess with the intensity. Ah, that's pretty cool. Image scale, so we can size the image. All right, so there's that one, which is really pretty cool. I like the idea of being able to do that. And all of this stuff is also drag and drop. So let's see, some 3D rotate text. Let's see if they're customizable. All right, here we go. We got there, and let's see. So we can do left to right, right to left, top to bottom. Let's hit top to bottom, see how that looks. That's pretty cool. Oh, all right. So let's bring this back. We can do extrusion depth. So if you want to make it less or more on the 3D, you can really mess with the bevel as well. Bevel width. All right. Let's bring the size down. So under here is for the reflection and stuff like that. All right. So now I'm going to drag this one, drop that and see. Let's check and see what this looks like. It's a background. Yeah. Looks like we can make a bunch of edits here. We can change our gradient there. You can even bring in your own background. But remember, these files should be PNG files. You can drag your own logo, put that in there. So if you want a logo. So you can also add your logo in here. Just go ahead and click the logo graphic. And whatever you put in there for your logo is gonna pop in there. That's awesome. So I just want to keep this video very short and to the point, just about the updates for the beta 6. Let me know in the comments, what are you most excited about for this? And tomorrow's video is still coming out as normal time, so be sure to stick around for that. And here's a couple other videos here. You want to check them out, and I'll see you in the next one.